everyone, I'm Sarah and welcome to the Best of the Music Jam. This week we'll be showing you some of our favourite moments from 2012. Enjoy.
It was that in North London in some pub, and we decided to have a couple of drinks, and then we had some more drinks, and I probably had about 10 tequilas before we went on stage because we were early and we waited and we were really drunk, and by the time we got onto stage it was absolute disaster, all of us. Like, you know, you kind of think, yeah, I'm gonna get on and be rock and roll and be so drunk, and we got up there and we just died a death, and that was pretty embarrassing.
That is why
because
we have
the. Because you don't feel cool afterwards, you feel pretty shit.
That's why we have the no drinking rule,
which
except for the lead singer.
Adhere to.
The lead singer, because you know they all get pissed and they like. With me, I'm like strike a pose. There's nothing to it. I'm gonna get you. I'm wet between my thighs.
All the music videos we've done recently, everybody wants to make me look like some crazy weirdo. And it's like, there's another one coming out now, like, I'm like strapped to like a chair and I'm like in a cell and, you know what I'm saying, like, yeah, I'm getting typecast as a psychopath, you know, like, but yeah, I think it's just kind of like, music videos are really important because it's another dimension for you to kind of get really creative and brand yourself and do something different and out the box and make it go the distance. It's cool now that most videos are viewed on the net as well, so you don't have to, you know, the censorship thing is kind of different, so you can be more creative. And yeah, cool tanked up to my grill. Run up in a jam so slick. Came straight out of the field. Head to the boy like, yo, can't see, hook me up one of them things. Back two shots to the head. Then I drop a one ice in a drink. Zop, zop, look who's back in the zone. Out here we're trying to catch those frills. Whole set pop free to the dome. You can find me by the speaker. What time I be by the mic. Beg a franchise mid to the ether. Come and get deep in the cut all night.
What kind of message do you think you guys send out to younger people through your music?
Mixed messages.
How do you think the London psytrance scene compares to the psytrance scene in other countries?
I think it's pretty cool. Like recently, over the past year or two, they started having a wider approach to what they sort of play. Like I remember coming to like London parties in the last sort of year or so, and like they were quite, I don't know, enclosed in what they would play. It was always seemed to be some sort of style. It was sort of bordering around 145 to 150. And I think over the past maybe year or two, it's sort of branching out. And they're playing a lot more different sub-genres within the style. Like it's a lot faster in place, a lot techier. So I think it's getting really good. It's really, really cool.
I think a lot of the warehouse parties are really cool, but then when it comes to like doing festivals, like we have laws over here in the UK that stop us playing music at like 5-6 o'clock in the morning, whereas in places in Europe it just continues on, so it's a bit of a different vibe as well. Plus the weather's nicer too, so that's a bit better.
Thank you. was used on horseback, allegedly. Is that
apparently,
correct?
I'm unsure.
And was there sufficient or adequate clothing and harness support for the horse whilst the rider was playing the instrument?
I believe it was all bareback. Yeah.
Bareback.
Yeah.
Okay. There we go.
Every night I hear a crow, a Russian lullaby.
More of a morose, reflective.
Yeah, kind chin of vibe. A lot of chin stroking. Yeah.
A lot of unhappy people.
A lot of finger guns.
And that's fine.
Slightly uncomfortable at first.
Yeah.
And then we slowly break the ice.
But if you are into that type of thing, swinging, then please come and see us.
Somewhere there may be a land that is free for you and me in Russia.
I know you can get a life and know what I hear, a knocking on your door with a rat's tap tap. I know with a bit of control you could be a little bit of...
It's been the best crowd so far.
Do you know what? Like, we've toured the UK so much on support tours, and just to like come out and be like selling out pretty much every night, you know, in places that we just used to have like the worst gigs in the world, like, just means everything. Like, the whole 10 days has been like easily some of my best shows of the year, like ever, that we've ever done. Some of the best shows we've ever done.
All the crowds have surprised us.
Yeah.
All of them, every single.
John Doe, our bass player, kind of gets, he's just kind of was born with an unfortunately funny streak where most things that he'll do in a day are pretty good entertainment. So I think our most entertainment in a day is our bass player John Doyle. Just watch him. You can watch him for hours, just going about his day, and it's better than watching the telly. I've been going so crazy for maze, and I wait for today's better land to be sleeping in hell. Like a fragment climbing back into my shell. And it's great that you make him a change. I became it and raised locked up, but I ain't. And I saw it got tough, but I'm blaming myself. Long stop feeling pain from my girl. Long that and away from the world for a minute. Friends in the weight of the world that I live in. And I don't want to give it, but honestly, I'm finished. And the quality diminished. And I'm feeling kind of sick of short line. And seems your life bitches. Never took time, I did my three wishes. Bring it all line and keep myself singing. Could say that I scored, I ain't winning, but mate, that's winning.
What would you say are some of your best memories from playing at gigs?
Ryan getting naked in Hamburg.
Yeah, that was quite a recent memory. That was quite good.
That was a night of a lot of 10% lager and a big litre can.
Caitlin's broke a banjo to bits a couple of times. Both been quite fun times.
Fell out the back of the van, that was quite stressful.
Yeah, that was after we woke up in the van, that's where we had to sleep.
Yeah. Sleeping in the van, I think, is the worst part.
Three nights in a Belgium services in the ice cold, sleeping in the van was pretty
crap. What advice would you give up and coming bands?
Get out while you can, anyway. Yeah,
do it start while you're young.
Hire professionals, don't have people with Chris the Pants.
don't have like mandolins and banjos.
No.
They always
just
break.
Get a job, don't get any tattoos, get a haircut and just grow up, to be honest.
If you could be reincarnated as anything, what would you come back as?
I always thought I'd like to come back as an orange tree. You ever climbed an orange tree? No, they're all right, man. They have all little spikes down the bottom, and then they just hang out, man. Or a cat. I'd like to be a cat, but like with someone that really cared about me, you know, like that, you know? That's a lucky thing to be, I think. You know what I'm saying, you know? Like, I look at my cat and I think, fuck. I mean, he gets whatever he wants. With raised glasses, we'll grift your system.
Here come the drums. If it was your last day on Earth, how would you spend it?
I'd probably do a lot of MDMA. honestly, really, if that was it, what the fuck? You might as well go out feeling good, you know? Really, that would be it, you know? I would probably be running around naked on MDMA. That would be probably my deal.
Have you ever been naked in public?
Yeah, well, a few times, I guess. Yeah, I don't know, you know. On MDMA, I have. That's why I would want to do it. It's all right, man. With a crowbar at 3 in the morning.
We are the Valve Teens, and you are watching the...
Hi, we're Loose Connect.
Yo, what's up? This is Metropolis.
We're the Velvet Teens. Okay, one.
Yeah, what's up? This is Metropolis.
Orifice Fogart.
DJ No Names.
We're Foreign Beggars and we're listening, we're chilling on the...
Hi, we're the Swing Ninjas and you're watching The Music Jam.
Hi, we're Loose Connection and you're watching The Music Jam.
Yeah, what's up? This is Metropolis.
Orifice Fogart.
No Names.
We are Foreign Beggars. And we're chilling out here on the Music Jam with the homegirl Sara. Dunno!
We're the Velveteens and you're watching the Music Jam.
Woo!
Hi, we're the Skints.
You're watching the Music Jam.
Woo! That's it for this year, but be sure to check out what we have in store for you in 2013. Of course, you can follow us on our social networking pages stated below to keep updated with what's happening in the music scene. Wishing you all happy holidays and a great new year.
Stop, look who's back in the zone. Out here we're trying to catch those frills.